Sir, in India, 40 million hectares, or 12% of our geographical areas, is exposed to recurring floods. But there is something which I want to draw the attention of the House to, that is the changing course of the river. Technically, it is not classified as a flood and hence does not qualify for any rehabilitation measures. All people who are affected by it are not getting any relief. Sir, when we talk about natural calamity and preparedness, only 192 dams against the 4,728 dams have some kind of emergency action plan in place. The Central Water Commission provides inflow forecast for only 28 of them. Sir, I don't know how much time it will take before we have the standard operating procedures for deployment of the NDRF. Sir, my other colleagues before me have already said that the NDMA has not been holding meetings regularly. Even when my colleague spoke on the Uttarakhand disaster, it was pointed out. So we know we have not even learned from our mistakes. Sir, we would like to mention here the situation in Bengal also. So almost 40% of our area is flood prone. 111 blocks amounting to 37,660 square kilometers is prone to recurring floods. So the steps that we have taken, we want to share it with the rest of our esteemed colleagues because we think it will help them. So we have now 24/7 emergency operational centers in the state secretariat working round the clock. A disaster SMS alert system to send warning signals to all officials up to the Gram Panchayat system. Disaster management team in among all our police forces. All district headquarters have a quick response team under the DM. There is a close cooperation between disaster management, fire, civil defense. And so there is a core committee under the chief secretary which meets once during the month to review normal situations and preparedness. Sir, my suggestions are that the National Disaster Response Fund and the National Disaster Mitigation Fund must be created at the earliest. The source of each fund and its linkage with respective state fund must be specified in the Act of the Rules. So the advisory committee, which had ceased to exist in 2010, has not been reconstituted. It is recommended that this committee should be reconstituted at the earliest because it forms a significant organ of NDMA, giving it expert advice. So the National Institute of Disaster Management should function as an autonomous body in respect to its activities and human resource practice, and not a subordinate organization of NDMA. The disaster management set up at the district authorities can be strengthened so that district authorities can be the first effective responders in case of a disaster. Sir, I would like to save a lot of time here and just end. We have suffered from Ayla, we have suffered from so many things. We are doing, but our efforts need central assistance. Even last week, 60 trawlers have gone missing due to sudden cyclonic storm in Bay of Bengal. Hundreds of fishermen are still reported to be missing. So we want that the National Disaster Force comes to the rescue and financial assistance to the kin of these people. Thank you.